carefully observed the gentle Smurfs at first. I wanted to understand how they could live such simple and decent lives. They were wary of me at the beginning, but slowly I began to earn their trust. It wasn't long before the gentle Smurfs accepted me as one of their own. Smurfs and I grew to understand each other. They shared with me their art of picking Smurf berries. And I shared with them stories of my country's forefathers. Of course, it wasn't long before I fell in love with Smurfette. We're from two different worlds, and yet we spoke the common language of passion.
These are the morning announcements.
Shh! Papa Smurf was displeased at first. He told Smurfette I wasn't a real Smurf and we could never be happy. But I eventually proved myself to Papa Smurf by picking more Smurf berries than any Smurf had ever Smurfed before. Finally, all was right with the world. But then, a crisis. Clumsy Smurf burst into the Smurf ceremony to say that humans had come to destroy all of Smurfland. No! No, you must leave the noble Smurfs alone! Who's behind all this? I should have known. Windy!
Out of my way!
Windy, what are you doing here?
Smurf berries are worth a lot of money! With all those Smurf berries, I can power the SKU for the entire year!
Windy, I know you're president of our SKU, but you can't just dig up the Smurf land!
Fuck the Smurfs! They can suck my fat tits!
How many Smurf berries is enough, Windy?
You can suck my fat tits, too!